Welcome to Joanna's Library. Enjoy the story. Show and Tell by Rob Bidoff. Meet Class 2L. These kids are excited. Today's Show and Tell Day, and you are all invited. Meet Mr. Lumsden. He is their teacher. A giant mustache, his most prominent feature. Remember, he says with a smile in his eyes, the child that impresses me most wins a prize. A hush fills the classroom. It's time to begin. Adam, you're the first. Show us what you've brought in. Well, says the boy, I have treasure indeed. A small piece of sunshine, this sunflower seed.
A sunflower seed?
That's so boring, shouts Betty. I've got a whole tin of bright blue spaghetti. I think you agree that mine beats yours, hands down. That seed is so tiny and boring and brown. Blue pasta, says Charlie. I guess it's okay, but my hat is the best thing that you will see today. Nonsense, says Darcy. My gold violins are far more impressive. And so it begins. From Eddie, snap, snap, Venus fly traps, one bunch. From Florence, a sandwich is brought in for lunch. From Isaac, a painting. From Jesse, a stamp. From Kenzo, these feathers. From Lily, this lamp. George has a set of his granddad's falsies. And Holly, a jolly red robot called Keys. Mo has a laser sword, Nelly, a carrot. Here's Oliver's spacesuit and Pamela's pirate. Quite an impressive collection so far. But wait, turn the page, we are raising the bar. Here's the new leader, it's Quinn, by a distance. He's brought in the speediest car in existence. But hold on a second, 'cause 2 minutes later, Rebecca walks in with her pet alligator. Oh my, look what Sylvia found in the park. And who's this here? The Queen of Denmark. And our friend Ulysses enters the room with monster in tow from Loch Ness, I assume. Looks like this card is the ace in the pack. Two Violet appear with Big Ben on her back. Give it up, folks! A big hand for the winner. But no, William makes her look like a beginner. Can he be beaten? The next person may know. It's Sansi, and she's got a red hot volcano. The champion. Wait. Have we spoken too soon? 'Cause Yao's just arrived, and he's holding the moon. Darkness, a total eclipse of the sun. Yao's moony moment has stopped all the fun. But look, bringing light to the end of our story, it's Zog the Explorer from Alpha Centauri. Zog gathers fly traps, the robot, the pirate, the car, the feathers, the painting, the carrot, the monster, the sandwich, the spacesuit, Big Ben. He ties them all onto his spaceship. And then he tows them away to a cosmic museum. They're on display now, if you'd like to go see them. Back in the classroom, it's quiet, indeed. The only thing left, Adam's sunflower seed. And so, Mr. Lumsden, a smile in his eyes, walks over to Adam and hands him the prize. This seed, says the teacher, is certainly tiny. It looks pretty boring, not flashy or shiny. But, he explains, as he kneels down beside it, like all the best things, it has magic inside it.
Thanks for listening. See you next time.